It's fight week and you still have a couple of pounds to lose until the weigh-ins and you're stressed out that you're not going to make it. Well, I got you boy, because today in this video I'm going to share with you 3 strategies that I personally use that helps me make the weigh-ins safely and to be ready to fight and win. So, let's get started. The first and the most important thing you must be careful and be aware of it is to not cut a lot of weight during the fight week and during the fight camp. I usually during the fight week I cut around 4 to 5 pounds and during the fight camp usually 6 to 7 pounds. I don't cut a lot of weight. I cut 15 pounds for a fight, but it didn't do well. It was a shit fight. I didn't win. It was a draw and I was only focused on losing weight and it wasn't really great experience. So I don't recommend you cutting a lot of weight for your fight, but you can start cutting weight during 4 to 5 weeks before your fight, starting cutting a little bit of weight and during the fight week to start cutting those last pounds. Be careful to not have a lot of pounds to cut during fight week. It will drain you of your energy and you will be only focusing on weight cut and you must be focusing on your strategies on how to fight. If you cannot cut weight during the fight camp where you can be disciplined and where you can cut a lot of weight, stick to a bigger weight class. Up your weight class. Maybe there is your weight class where you feel really good, feel very okay, feeling very strong, energized, and to be focused on winning the fight. This is the most important part in preparation of a fighter, to win his fights, not to win only the weigh-ins and lose the fight. No, that's not the goal. The goal is to win the fight. Yes, the weigh-in is a part in the preparation of a fighter, but it's not all the things that a fighter must do. It's not the all be all. No, the weigh-ins is just a part to make the fight a little bit equal, but cheating on the weigh-ins won't help you win those fights every time. So be careful what your weight is. Let's say I'm going to fight at 75 kilograms my next fight and now I'm around 80-81 kilograms. So I will start cutting until I will reach 77 kilograms and in the last 3 days I will cut those 2 kilograms, those 4 pounds. So it won't be hard for me to lose 2 kilograms in 3 or 4 days before the weigh-ins, because I will do the second step that I'm going to tell you right now. I'm going to eat only 3 meals per day, smaller portions, because I won't need that much energy, because I won't be training really hard during this time. I will be only doing strategy work, just a little bit jump rope, shadow boxing, a little bit of bag and pads, but not on high intensity level. And I will eat only 3 meals. I will eat breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Small portions just to satisfy my needs. A little bit, 2 eggs in the morning, a little bit of chicken with some veggies in the afternoon, and maybe a little bit of steak in the evening to give me some energy, but with veggies. I will cut the carbs in the last 3 or 4 days, the complex carbs like bread, pasta, rice, potatoes. I won't eat that type of carbs. I will eat a little bit of honey to boost my energy up, to give me energy. I will eat a little bit of honey so to give me energy, but not a lot. A few teaspoons of honey a day won't make that worse. But you must keep your calories down, your effort not that high, just a little bit of, you know, to get that sweat going, but do not eat a lot. If you eat just 3 small meals per day, you will see improvements from day to day. You will see how you will lose 1 pound a day easily in your next 3 or 4 days before your weigh-in. Start by doing this strategy, just eating 3 meals per day, 3 or 4 days before your weigh-ins, just before your weigh-ins. This is not a method to lose weight fast, for, you know, lose fat. No, this is to lose water weight, to lower your glycogen levels, to lower your water weight, to get rid of those 2 or 3 pounds of water from your body, just eliminating the carbs, and you will make the weigh-ins. And if you still have 1 or 2 pounds to lose on weigh-ins day, you can do a hot bath. Yes, because it will be safely. If you're doing 2 or 3 hot baths during the weigh-ins, you will be drained of energy because you will lose too much water weight, it will be really hard to get back to your energy levels that you had a few days ago. So I usually do only one hot bath in the morning, and if I really have to do just 1 pound, I will jump some rope, I will get into a sauna suit, I will do some jumping rope, and that will help me lose that 1 pound or maybe 2 pounds in just half an hour of jumping rope, shadow boxing, but it won't be draining my energy that much like a hot bath doing 10 to 15 minutes hot baths, doing 2 or 3 times this thing. Doing 2 or 3 hot baths will drain you a lot of energy and will be harder for you to get back on your feet. Why I'm saying this? Because I did all of these things. I tested on myself and I can say that it's not a good feeling. It's not a great experience. If you want to experience how hell it is, do 2 or 3 hot baths and you will see how hell feels like. It's excruciating, it's really really hard, and I don't recommend you to do it. Just do one hot bath, 20 minutes, relaxing, eliminating the water. When you start sweating, you will stay there for 10 minutes and you can lose 1 pound or maybe 2 pounds easily. If you don't drink water one night before the weigh-ins, you can lose 2 pounds easily just from not drinking water and peeing. It's not that hard if you approach it correctly by the start of your fight camp. If you're starting your diet 4 weeks before your fight and during the fight camp, having 3 balanced meals and having some snacks here and there, training and eating clean during these 4 weeks, you can manage to lose like 6 to 7 pounds easily in 4 weeks just by training, eating clean, and you can make the weigh-ins really easy, and you will be focusing on your fighting strategy. You're going to be focused on how to win the fight, and you will win the fight because you won't be focused how to lose weight and what to do to lose those a few pounds that you only have left to lose before the weigh-ins. So I hope this strategy will help you. I personally use these strategies and I hope it will help you too in your next fight. Comment down below if you like this video. Subscribe to the channel. Until next time, stay strong, be unstoppable, champ.